Hello, here's the Silicon Valley Free-moN why not module, or part of it. And we need some shotgun shacks. So I'm going to try and show you how to build some simple shacks out of styrene. Here's the picture of a prototype. It's always good to work off a prototype. These are from up in the Yukon, I think. But you can get your measurements and look directly from that, and it'll keep everything real. All right, let's move to the workbench. We're going to use some evergreen clapboard styrene. You can see I've already used some. And then we're going to use some doors and some windows from Titchy and Grantline. First step is just to measure everything out. I'm going to be making four shacks at the same time, so it's going to be about, side walls are going to be about 8 feet tall. So you just make a little notch there, find a clapboard groove that's about 8. And the great thing about clapboard is that you don't even need a straight edge. You can just pull the knife, the very, very sharp knife, along the clapboard. Then go back and mark the walls. It's going to be about 20 feet long. And then go ahead and score the wall sections. It's a lot easier just to make a whole bunch at once. So you just score and snap, score and snap. And then we're going to move on to the ends. The ends have the peak, right? So you can just, that's the edges, and then I'm going to go up a couple feet for the roof peak. I think it's about 15, it's going to be about 15 feet wide. So you can go ahead and put the 15 foot mark plus the 7.5 mark in the middle. And then mark the peak. So you're marking the edges and then marking the peak. Score and snap the whole thing. And then you can just take each end section. I find it's easier to place the knife in the correct spot and then move the straight edge up next to it. Score and snap. And to get the roof peak, place the knife on the side, push the straight edge up against it, lining it up with the top of the peak, draw it a couple light passes, and then snap it off. And you just repeat for the other side. You don't need to shove the knife all the way through the styrene, you just score it a little bit and then snap. And there you have the end piece. And that should work out pretty well. All right, cut out all the ends and sides. Also got all the windows and doors ready. I like to put everything in piles. You'll notice that one group doesn't have a whole as many windows or doors as the other, because that's not, it's gonna be up against some hills. So not even gonna see that, the back of it. We need some 0.04 by 0.04 square styrene to put on as the corner posts of the shack. So you cut one to fit the wall, and then you can use your chopper to cut a whole bunch of them. Careful with those fingers. Don't want to be called stumpy. So the front is, has a little, the door is recessed a little bit, creating a little porch in the front. So we need about a 2 foot section to recess the door. So we want to cut that right now too. Right now we're just trying to get all the pieces together first before anything else. We need the subroof, which is going to be out of just regular 0.04 plain styrene. And just going to put about 2 feet past each side, so if, about 24 feet long, and about 10 feet wide, so it hangs over a little bit. You don't want it to hang too much, so you can always trim it later. But and then you, once you cut the first one, you can use the second one as a guide. So pretty fast, just cut, cut, cut. Doesn't have to be exact because it's the subroof. Here's a little trick. Once you get the two pieces of subroof, you just take some masking tape and use that to hold the two together. And then you have your subroof assembly that is a little flexible and will be able to fit. Okay, so to get the doors and windows, personally I never liked using styrene before because I always used the X-Acto knife to cut out the windows and doors, and that was a real pain, and I usually ended up cutting everything. So, but I found this nifty hole punch with a rectangle head at Michael's, a craft store, in the scrapbooking section. It's very cheap, so don't use it on more than 0.04 styrene, and go very easy when you press. But you can line everything up, get it square, and nibble away, and it creates a pretty square hole that fits the windows and doors. And then you can just adjust with a little filing to get everything flush and nice and square. The nibbling and the filing probably take the longest, is the longest part of building these shacks, so. But it's worth it to take the time because you want the doors and windows to sit pretty flush and not have big gaps around them or anything like that. But they should fit pretty well like that, and now you're ready to rock and roll with everything else. On the ends, I was originally going to use these Tichy windows, but looking at the prototype photo, they just look too big. So I got some of these Grant Line, a little bit smaller windows, and I'd like to use those. So I'm going to ignore my drawing that I already did, the line that I already drew, and I'm just going to start punching the windows out. Of course, once you do one, you can just use it to overlap and use a pencil to kind of outline where it's going to go. Of course, that's going to be a little bit smaller than what it should be, so you can go back and fill in up to the clapboard line. Clapboard's great because it's already got all the lines right there for you. You don't have to do a whole lot. You can just use the lines in the clapboard to line up for the window holes. So, file away a little bit. All right, the last thing we got to do is to cut the front in half because we want to recess the door about 2 feet. So just score, snap, and then we'll put the little 2 foot section in between that. We've got all of our piles now. The last thing is to I'm going to use the sprue of the windows. I think it'll make a pretty groovy stovepipe exhaust chimney. So I'm going to cut a couple of those off and save those for later. Now, to prep for painting, just take a paper towel and some double-sided tape. Put a chunk of double-sided tape right on the paper towel and then peel off the top. And then you can put all the little pieces along the edge of the double-sided tape. This will make it so that when you use the spray can, it doesn't blow all the little small little pieces everywhere, and you're not chasing all the little pieces with the spray can across your garage floor. One paper towel will be all the pieces that will have gray trim at the end, so the windows, the end posts, and whatnot. The other paper towel will have the wall sections, which will be white at the end. So give everything a gray primer, both front and back of all the pieces. So these are all the backs of the walls. And when you're done with that, you need to hit the front with gray primer too. But it's a white building! Yeah, I know, but you hit it with gray primer anyway, because you want it to kind of show through. So get that done, move all the trim pieces away, and then you can hit the front with white spray paint and just mist it, like heavy mist. Don't flood it, and then the gray will show through and it'll look a lot older. Give it a little bit more of an aged look. And yeah. So we'll stop here for part one, but we'll put it all together in part two. See you soon.